So that makes you the most diverse person I have ever met at UTR.
Thank you. Thank you.
Going on, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Fung Bros on the Street. We're here at the University of Texas in Austin, Texas. Now, there are a lot of different types of people on the UT Austin campus. So today we wanted to ask some students about the different ethnicities here, how they're mixing,
or if they're staying within their own little bubbles.
So let's find out today about the
college racial bubble. Let's go.
I feel like there's a lot of different types of people around. Do you feel like they're all existing in their own ethnic bubbles, or they're integrating?
It's a little bit of both.
Yeah, there's a lot of interracial friends. I don't know so much about dating because we're in College of Natural Sciences and we don't have time for that.
I think they're slowly mixing with each other, but for now I feel like there are bubbles.
I feel like my group is very like diverse.
There's always that bubble inside, like bubbles, I guess, like of Asians. There's like bubbles of VSA people and FSA people. And
even within Asians, there's inter-Asian bubbles.
Yeah, exactly.
We are here with
Dana.
And Dana, you told me you are a Vietnamese American girl in a white sorority who dates an Indian guy.
Yes.
So that makes you the most diverse person I have ever met at UTR.
Thank you. Thank you.
The Indian guy you're dating also in an Indian frat?
Yes, he is.
So he's in a bubble.
I mean, there will always be people who love other cultures and who will go out of their way to, you know, mix with other cultures. But then there are always people who are just like happy to be in their little bubble. And so, I mean, it should change. I hope it does change.
You're optimistic, sort of.
We believe in the melting pot.
Generally, a lot of Asian people join Asian fraternities, but you are joining a mainstream fraternity, correct?
Right.
And which, demographically speaking, it's mostly
white people.
What made you want to join the mainstream fraternity rather than the Asian fraternity?
Actually, I moved around a lot, so like I used to live in Europe and I live here now, so I moved around a lot.
You're used to not being around a lot of Asians.
Yeah, basically, yeah.
Like visually, if you just see it, you're like, okay, that's a white frat, that's a black frat, that's a Jewish frat, there's an Asian frat, Indian frat.
You can tell, you can tell.
And I think, yeah, there's maybe sort of that disconnect between the Greek system and like the rest of the university as a whole.
I would definitely agree. Yeah, as sororities, when you see them, they all look alike, you know, they're all of the same race, you know, wearing the same stuff.
Do you feel like you have a pretty interesting perspective because like you're Jewish, which is like, and it is kind of white, but it's also kind of not.
Like my dad used to be in ZBT, he said, I mean, nowadays it's a lot different than it was back then because he says they got a lot of shit for it back then, but nowadays, I mean, no one talks down on us for being Jewish or anything like that.
Is there some tension from that group that's kind of like, you know, they used to be 95%, now they're only 45%?
I have friends that still like get pissed off, like, oh, like he got picked because he was black or he was Asian, like that's why I didn't get picked, like there's too many of me and they want more.
Have you ever had to defend like the fobbier Asians to your white friends?
I think it was last week. It was in front of like the PCL library. It's one of the libraries here, and there were like a bunch of these Asian fobby Korean guys. They were like just smoking cigarettes outside. And they were just like, man, they look so weird. And they were like listening to K-pop like out loud. And I was just like, I mean, they were kind of like judging. They're just like, man, why are they doing that? That's just like, that's really. And I was just like, I mean, they're from Korea. It's like their culture and that's how they were raised, you know?
You kind of put it in perspective for them.
I think there's some tension in the respect that like people come from many different cultural backgrounds, and I think that takes adjusting. But I think that having that exposure to diversity influenced by new cultures is a good thing, not necessarily a bad tension. But
maybe I feel like there's more like respect for cultural differences here than when I was like back living in Kansas or going up to school there.
So you come to UT Austin, where it kind of has this long-standing tradition of what's a true Longhorn. You got to tailgate, you got to wear cowboy boots, which is not Asian culture at all, whatsoever. So how do you feel like you fit into that? You're like, oh, I got to assimilate. Is there pressure? Or you're just like, I don't care, I do me.
Me personally, I don't feel like I have to like go out of my way to like pretend that I'm interested in sports when I'm not, or like dress up on game day.
Well, I don't think we should necessarily blend in because like you said, we do live in America and that's a melting pot for all cultures.
I want to be in my own bubble and I want to step foot into the culture because I don't want to leave college like not experience something that I could have.
So you are currently in the process of attempting to break out of the bubble?
Yeah. I'm just ready to try new things since I'm really shy. So ever since I've been went to college, I've been more open.
Okay.
But I definitely think it's like a huge, huge deal because, you know, we are in America.
Are you interested in the football games? Because the football here and basketball here is such a big deal.
I guess it's kind of getting bigger, but yeah, generally like the idea is that football is better than the like soccer.
How much do you care about football?
Not much, yeah.
I'm actually more of a soccer fan, so like, sorry, football. But I do love any sort of sport.
I was like, oh, you don't understand. You live in Texas and part of UT, so he like sat me down. He gave me like an hour lecture about football. So I finally understand.
I think it just depends on like the group of people that come in, you know? Like there are those that are really like extroverts and they want to like meet everyone and like mingle with everyone. But there are those that really want to keep it in their bubble and just hang out with like what they're comfortable with.
How do you feel like about people coming to America? Should they pretty much make a pretty strong effort to assimilate into the culture? Because let's say, for example, a lot of the new students that are come from other countries, their parents weren't into football because football is a very American sport. I heard some people even saying, well, what's going to happen to the football program once this school is like 67% minorities because they don't even care about tailgating and all those things.
In terms of like those long-standing cultural traditions, I really don't think football would really be affected because it's still, UT football is a national brand. It's still going to be on ESPN. It's still going to be, I mean, like white America is still going to watch it, whether it's the white America in Texas or the white America in Utah or Wyoming.
I've been in Texas for 13 years now. And so I like to consider myself a Texan. So I mean, I think it's a, you have to embrace the country you are in.
We're optimistic about the future of America.
All right, everybody, that's it for our UT Austin episode of Fung Bros on the Street.
What we found out today was basically that most students recognize that there is some segregation going on, but also a lot of mixing going on as well.
Most people we spoke to are optimistic about the future of America. And although there are some issues that we need to work through together, most people are looking forward to mixing more with other groups.
We'll be okay, I hope.
All right, you guys, that's it. Until next time, make sure you let us know any questions that you want to let us know in the comments section below. Until next time, we're out. Peace.
We are different, although, of course, we're under the umbrella of Asian, and I understand, obviously, India is in Asia, but, you know, oftentimes it is separated. Indians are kind of left out of the Asian conversation here. Why do you think they should be included?
I think in the bigger picture, we are all a minority in this country, and I think it makes more sense for us to come together and maybe, like represent our rights as Asians in America. So, I mean, I feel like that's a great reason for us to come together. Like, I mean, yeah, there are differences, but if we could just, like, accept our differences, I think that would be great. So, I mean, it makes sense to me.
Do you think Indians being Asians are closer to Chinese than, for example, like, Hispanics? Because the Hispanics are also a minority,